nuts and bolts of it is, you know, when I started off promoting, I didn't realise how big it was going to become. So I sort of went into this thing, sort of just went along, and I kept thinking, we're only going to have a year, 2 years of this, and then I'll find a proper job. And it just went absolutely through the roof. And, you know, one minute I'm doing an event every couple of months, and I was doing 20 events a month, and then I was going all around the world. So, and then I come out of it in 2003, and then actually seeing how it's just like evolved and gone even bigger now, I mean, it's just amazing. I mean, really, truly amazing. And to see the way that drum and bass is evolved, and it's gone all through the world. I mean, you know, you've got, you know, Sigma having number one hit records with Take That. You've got DJ Fresh and Rita Ora. So all this stuff's come out of it. So now everything's gone mainstream. So, you know, I still can't quite believe it's real, you know. I think the good thing about this film is I think people are going to watch it, and it's that thing where you have, you know, the people that are in it now that are maybe sort of 15 to 25s that are out partying. Then you've got the sort of 30-somethings that don't go out raving that much, but they still listen to the music. And then you've got the 40-pluses that have that fond memory of how it used to be. So really, this film is from anyone from 15 to 50. So, you know, I think they're all going to take something out of it. It's a journey. I think people will be shocked at some of the things that happen. But I also think that they're fine. There's a lot of funny stories, and there's a lot of emotional stuff in there as well. So,
in terms of the film that we're going to see tonight, how much of that is original footage versus archival stuff that's been pieced together?
Well, there's a little bit of original footage. I mean, obviously, all the interviews were done now, so they're recent. But the archive footage is from the events I used to put on, so you'll actually be able to see how it was back in the day. So many stories.
Hello, Ad. How are you, mate?
Yeah, wicked,
how are you? Good to see you, mate. It's exciting.
It's wicked, mate. Is that it?
How you doing?
Yeah, good.
Yeah, so there's loads of funny stories, but I'd say there's, the whole film's full of funny stories. So there isn't one. It's probably 30. So many stories.
Hello, Ad. How are you, mate?
Yeah, wicked,
good.
Good
to see you, mate.
It's
exciting.
It's wicked, mate.
How you doing?
Yeah, good.
So there's loads of funny stories, but I'd say there's, the whole film's full of funny stories, so there isn't one. It's probably 30.
And my last question, what else have you got coming up the rest of the year and beyond? Always a busy man, always your finger in a lot of pies.
Yeah, we've got a horror film coming out called The Heiress. We've got the Garage Nation documentary coming out about the garage scene. And then we've got Rise of the Foot Soldier 5 we're making. We've got a film about Shah Varan. We've always got a lot of stuff happening, so there'll be a lot of things happening this year, so watch this space.
Hi, I'm DJ Rap, and I'm here to see United Nations.
Amazing to have you here for tonight. How excited are you for this celebration of the amazing history of drum and bass?
I'm really excited. Finally, we're going to get represented in a positive way by someone who actually knows about the scene and is a part of it. That's a good thing.
Why do you think that this genre of music has exploded into the mainstream, particularly in the last few years? We really seem to have seen a lot of collaborations, a lot of mainstream artists adopting this style.
One word: authenticity. That's it. It's real. It's not made up, it's not fake. It doesn't matter how you look. It's about your production skills, and it's always about the music, and that's what drum and bass is about. Well, I'm pretty much excited to be out, because normally I'm like a cavewoman in boxer shorts in a studio. So I've got releases every month, I've got music coming out. My life is just music, labels, DJing, gigs, and doing a bit of film stuff as well. So yeah, I'm just doing what I do, and I've been doing since I was 14.
I think obviously, particularly on the DJ front, it's often described as a male-dominated space. Do you think that is still the case, or do you think it's changing?
From my point of view, it matters not. It matters about your production. But yeah, obviously it's dominated. But I think there's a lot of beautiful women producers coming up now, and that's you know, the way it is. But at the end of the day, it's all about your production here. Yes, it's male dominated, but if you focus on that, then I don't focus on that crap. I make my own way.
Hi, I'm Ray Keith. I'm one of the pioneers of Jungle Drum and Bass, and one of the original DJs that was at One Nation with Terry Turbo and all the original DJs back in the day.
It's amazing to have you here tonight. What does it mean for you to have the journey of drum and bass celebrated on screen in this way?
I think it's really important. I think it's good for our scene. I think it's about time that's, you know, Terry's in a position to kind of relay what was going on back in those days and all the different cultures underneath that is brought to the scene. You know, jungle drum and bass now has played on TV, radio, daytime, and it's evolved. So it's great to be a big part of that.
For people who aren't maybe as familiar as they should be with drum and bass, can you talk about what the unique magic of this genre of music is and what is so the true spirit of the genre?
I think the spirit of the genre is basically making music and being able to make music at home. That was the whole thing about not having to go to a major, being an independent, having your own label. And also, music is an expression. So it was bringing out your own personality into that music or the labels that set it up originally.
And in terms of the amazing crossover success we're seeing, how proud are you to see so many mainstream artists now incorporating D&B into their style?
I think it's great. I think at the end of the day, it's like early hip-hop. It's like early hip-hop. It's like, it's now mainstream. People are listening to it. It's at a younger audience, and it's more captivating. And I think that's really important that we keep pushing the boundaries of the music. So, yeah, we're all super proud. Do you know what I mean?
I think if this film inspires particularly a younger generation to get involved in exploring this history, who are the top artists you would say they need to start with? Who are the real fathers of D&B?
I think at the end of the day, when we started back in 88 and 89 and the 90s, we kind of laid the foundation. If you look at early hip-hop, they did the same thing. And now it's 25 years old. We kind of paved the way for this generation to come through. So we're super proud of that, you know what I mean?
Beyond a great night ahead of you tonight, what else have you got coming up in 2020?
My album's just come out, 2020. We went to number one in the Juno download chart, so I was really super happy with that. It's out on CD. I've been doing some acting and film stuff as well, so some more stuff later on this year. Can't really talk about that. But yeah, just, you know, still DJing. Got a weekly show every week. Got some mad numbers on Facebook Live every Thursday between 12 and 2. So still involved in producing and making music, you know what I mean?
How happy and proud are you to see drum and bass and its unique history celebrated on screen?
I'm really happy. I'm really excited because it's the biggest thing so far for drum and bass film-wise. So, yeah, I'm really excited.
And, I mean, for people who maybe aren't as familiar with this genre of music as they could be, can you describe what the unique magic, what's so special about drum and bass?
For me, what's so special about jungle drum and bass is that it's a UK thing. It was born over here, and I was part of that birth, you know what I mean? So that's why it's special to me.
I mean, as someone who was there on the ground floor at the start of that journey, do you have your most precious memories, like stories from back in the day, things that you really smile about when you think of on nights like tonight?
Yeah, doing pirate radio, breaking into warehouses, setting up, not me personally, but that's what people have done, setting up sound systems, raving till for 2 days straight, you know what I mean? So you don't do that nowadays, but back then that's how it was.
And I think obviously Jungle is a label that's very on trend at the moment, very in vogue. Why do you think that is? Why do you think people seem to be embracing Jungle, or at least the label?
I think, well, one, like I said before, it's a UK thing. So, you know, the youths are gonna embrace it anyway. And plus, a lot of us that are involved in it from back in the day, we was all going in different walks of life, and it brought us all together. And there's a whole heap of different ideas because everyone's different in jungle drum and bass. So, you know, at the end of the day, it is special because it's a UK thing. Simple.
If there are people watching this who maybe aren't that familiar with it and are starting their own journey with jungle drum and bass, who are the top DJs? Who are the people that you think they really should be listening to kick them off on that journey?
Me? I don't know, like Andy C, Mickey Finn, Groove Rider, Fabio, Randall, Jumpin' Jack Frost, to name but a few. There's loads more. Brocky, MC Depp, MC GQ. There's loads of us. Loads of us.
All great names. My final question, looking forward to the rest of the year and beyond for yourself, is there anything you're excited about at the moment working on?
Yeah, I've got a few tours coming up. I've got Australia and Canada in March. Loads of dates over here, and possibly October, Australia.
Hi, my name is Charlotte Devaney.
Charlotte, it's amazing to have you with us tonight. Tonight's celebrating, of course, the unique history of drum and bass on screen. But I'm curious if you can start by telling us a little bit about the beginning of your journey with One Nation and your unique entry into DJ Superstar.
So I'm now a DJ, and I've also done acting, been in Hollywood films, and done lots of stuff in the entertainment business, like modelling. But I started out at One Nation. I started out as a dancer. And yeah, it really was my kind of entrance point, and drum and bass is like where I started out my musical journey, really. I've gone on to like make and play lots of other genres, but you know, drum and bass is where it started for me, basically. So,
I mean, what is so special, so unique about drum and bass?
Drum and bass, what makes drum and bass so unique and special is, first off, it's like a family. You know, I think once you're in the family, that's it, you know, and you can go off and do other things, but that family will always be there, and that's what I've found. Like, you know, I've explored so many different avenues within the entertainment business, but the drum and bass scene is always there. And of course, the music's wicked, you know, the vibe, there's not another vibe like it, really, you know, it's just, it's electric, so. Yeah, that's what makes it.
And I'm curious, I think when it comes to being a DJ, it's still very much seen as being a male-dominated space, but I think people like yourself are very much evidence that that's changing. How do you feel about that issue, that description of it as a male space?
I think DJing is still very male-dominated. You know, it is getting better for women, but I still think there's a long way to go. There's loads and loads of really talented female DJs out there, though, that are smashing it, which is an amazing thing. But I still think there's a long way to go for it to be kind of on an equal footing. But, you know, we're getting there. We're getting there. And, you know, it is great to see so many girls coming through. So, and, you know, I'm going to keep doing my thing and, you know, not letting anything stop me, basically. So,
glad to hear that. My final question, when you look to the rest of the year and beyond, what have you got coming up that you're excited about?
So 2020, I've got loads and loads of music coming out. My first release is going to be the 6th of March. And then after that, it's going to be a single every single month. So yeah, just lots and lots of music, lots of touring. Watch this space, check out my social media for everything that's going on with me, Charlotte Devaney.
I'm MC Ellaby, Garage MC. Been invited here tonight to see the drum and bass film. Big drum and bass fan. Love all the DJs, love all the MCs. I'm looking forward to seeing it.
How special and important do you think it is for the unique history of drum and bass to be celebrated and captured on screen in this way?
Well, you know, drum and bass was way before its time. I mean, you go back and you listen to some of the music. It's so still up to date. It's massive. 30 years, I mean, how many genres can go for 30 years and carry on going, playing the same tunes, same beat? It's the best genre in the world, to be honest with you. So,
and for people who aren't as into dance music as they should be, can you explain what the unique charm, what the appeal of drum and bass is amongst all the other different, and what defines drum and bass, I guess?
Okay, well, it's, I suppose it's just, you know, bits and pieces of everything, you know, like brought together, and so many sub-genres that come off of it, and it's just amazing. Like, whoever hasn't listened to drum and bass, go and listen to it, go to the raves, go and dance, enjoy yourself. Honestly, you had the best time ever.
People are inspired by this film. They want to get more into garage, drum and bass. Who are the top artists for you? Who are the DJs that they really should be starting out with?
Well, MC Skibbity and Shabba. Evil B, who's got that crossover into the garage of B-Live. All of them, they're all great. Just go and listen to it, buy the tape packs, listen to it on YouTube. Whatever you can get, wherever you can get it and listen to it.
Talking about yourself, what have you got coming up the rest of 2020 and beyond yourself?
We've got Proper Fest, which is a big festival going on in Essex. I'm a resident at UKG Brunch, which is a monthly event. We also do London Bound, which is a garage event. We did Thursday, I was with Luck and Neat doing a snow bombing at Mixed Mag, which went out to about 2.5 million people. So there's a lot coming up. Look out for me, Ellaby. I'll be there doing my thing. So,
are you excited for this celebration of drum and bass on screen?
Yep. This is like what you call now the opinion of everybody that's coming back, and you're getting to see what really happened back in those days, you know? Like, you hear a lot. But when you actually get to see it, especially for the people that was there, this is like a story that's never been told properly anyway.
What is the unique magic of drum and bass for you?
That was the energy that got me. Everyone will know about us from the Heartless Crew. We wanted to get into the drum and bass scene. We was fighting. It was locked like a vice those time there. So we came in through the garage, but we always wanted to be with the drum and basses because the energy is just electric. What can we say?
Curious, who are the DJs from that period that mean the most to you, that are the most special for you?
Boy, well, I have to big up man like Mampy Spliff. I mean, sorry. Mampy Swift. Yeah, I big up man like Funky Flirt, DVSD, and like, like Brocky is like one of the, my all time, you get me? Nicky Black Market, never I can stop. Him and Stevie Hyper D for me, and Brocky and that. And also, like I said, Funky Flirt, Shabadi, love it.
Final question, what have you got coming up yourself in 2020 and beyond?
2020, we've got some big things coming. Heartless Crew, as you know, we've got a show on BBC One Extra every Sunday, 7 to 9. So check us out on there. And yeah, we've got some music coming, guys. Hi.